It's Natalie. Welcome to another Makeup Monday. I'm going to share a makeup product review with you guys, and today I have this stuff. This is the Maybelline Dream Matte Mousse. I have the color Nude Light number 4. This is a mousse foundation similar to the Boots Mousse foundation, which I thought was totally awesome. This stuff, I'm not really a big fan so far. This is about my 5th or 6th time wearing it, and I'm going to do a full type of review where I'm going to apply it. You guys can see how it goes on my skin, the other products I'm wearing it with. Now, I didn't set this with any powder or anything just because I wanted to see how this baby did all by itself. And then I'm going to take my camera with me throughout the day so you can see how it wears on my face, what it looks like in natural light and like in my room and stuff like that. And then at the very end of the day so you can see how it held up and how it lasted. And if I sound a little nasally, it's because I have a cold and I don't feel that well. But I wanted to get this up for you guys. To apply my mousse foundation, I'm using this Royal & Langnickel. This is the stippler brush. I love using a stipple brush when I put on mousse foundation. The Dream Matte Mousse I picked up from Walgreens. It was $11.49, so it's kind of expensive for such a small amount of product. There is 0.64 ounces. Packaging is glass. Packaging is pretty nice, but there's not a lot of product in here. This does not contain sunscreen, which for me is really important, so kind of a thumbs down for not having sunscreen. The products I'm also wearing with this are my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. I love this stuff. It has been amazing. I just think it's fabulous. I wear this under my eyes wherever I need some concealing, and then I also use the Bare Minerals Well Rested Face and Eye Brightener. So yeah, I'm going to take the camera with me, film throughout the day, show you guys what this actually looks like on my skin. It doesn't feel heavy, but it feels like I have product on my face versus using like the Stay Luminous foundation or a Too Faced foundation, something that is a cream foundation. This stuff, I can tell that it's on my face, and I don't really like that feeling. I'm not too crazy about it, so we'll see how this wears throughout the day. And my hair is like, I don't know what I'm doing with my hair today. I can feel it like falling out of its ponytail. And this is another product I'm trying. I'm going to have a review. I picked up this and also some of the concealers from the Wet n Wild. This is the Illuminating Face Palette. I got two of the contouring palettes, and I just think it's awesome. Look at how pretty this is. So far, I really like this stuff. I'm wearing it on my face. Look at that glow highlight. I like it. So yeah, I'm gonna go meet my family for some lunch and to get my nails done. I'll see you guys soon. So this is my face at the end of the day. It is now nighttime, and I did forget to bring my camera with me. I normally bring a small camera with me when I leave the house to take pictures. I was going to film in natural daylight and share with you guys what the foundation looks like, but I left, where is it? Here it is. I left my camera at home. This is a camera I use when I'm out and about on the counter, and when I got home, it was still light outside. I was gonna film for you guys, and this is what happened. I don't know if you can see. If you're wondering how my puppy is doing, he chews on my stuff, and it kind of pisses me off. So he chewed my camera, and the screen does not work like when I turn it on. That's all I get. I was so bummed. So I didn't get to film for you guys. I really wish I would have remembered. I wish I would have remembered my camera, because since I left it at home, it got chewed by my dog that has been behaving very badly today. Does he chew anybody else's stuff? No, just mine. So, back to the foundation. As far as the wear goes, like I said, I don't really like how it feels on my face. I just am not really impressed with this foundation. I like the wear and the look of the liquid foundations that I've been trying and wearing lately. I feel like this one doesn't smooth my skin or fill in my pores like my other foundations do. It doesn't really look like natural skin. When you see me in person, you could tell that I have something sitting on top of my face. The coverage is medium, coverage to full coverage, I feel like when you try to put more on or layer it, it's not very buildable. So that's another thing I don't like about it. I feel like with the liquid foundations, I could put it light everywhere and then build the medium to full coverage only in the areas that I need it. So I think this foundation gets a thumbs down. I wasn't too impressed, especially because of the price and the photos that I saw, like in the commercial, and the way that the company made the foundation look was amazing, but you know, it wasn't too amazing. So I would not be purchasing this again. I wasn't too impressed. I like the other Maybelline liquid foundation, not the mousse. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you're having an awesome day, an awesome week. Happy New Year's to all of you guys, and I'll see you in my next video.